Hello students, now we are going to discuss the types of cosmic rays. Cosmic rays are divided into two types, that is the primary cosmic rays and the secondary cosmic rays, depending upon the height upon which the cosmic rays had occurred. So the cosmic rays are of two types, the primary rays and the secondary rays. So for the primary rays, these primary rays are highly energetic particles in the cosmic rays, and they possess energy of 10 raised to power 20 electron volt. So this is quite a high value of energy, and these high energy particles are falling upon the surface of the earth anywhere from the outer space, and it's falling in all directions. So these constitute the primary rays. The primary rays are generally composed of the protons, and these protons forms the 85% of the primary cosmic rays, whereas 10% is formed by the alpha particles and the rest 5% is the formation by the heavier nuclei, which consists of the nitrogen, carbon, oxygen, iron nuclei. So this is the constituent of the primary rays, where it is of 85% proton, 5% alpha particle, and 5% is constituted by the nuclei of carbon, nitrogen, oxygen, and iron, and other nuclei. So the primary rays reach at the top of the atmosphere isotropically, means they are reaching the top of the atmosphere in any direction, from any direction it can reach, and the value is same. And the rate at which they are reaching is same in all directions, and it is not varying with time. The primary rays expand their enormous energy. Since the primary rays were having their high energy, so they are expanding their energy, and due to high energy, they are colliding with the nuclei of the atmosphere. So they expand, and the inelastic collisions do with the nuclei of the nitrogen and oxygen in the Earth's upper atmosphere. And when they collide with the nitrogen and oxygen, they are resulting into the production of the secondary cosmic rays. So primary rays is the basis of the formation of the secondary cosmic rays. So what is next? The cosmic rays. What are the secondary cosmic rays? So the secondary cosmic rays are known as, or they are regarded as, the hard component of the cosmic rays. So they are regarded as the hard component of the cosmic rays, and we know that the hard cosmic rays intensity did not vary. So the intensity of the cosmic rays at the altitude of 50 to 60 kilometers remain constant, and it changes only when it is close to the surface of the earth, and it changes closer to the earth's surface due to the secondary cosmic rays. So the secondary cosmic rays are comprised of what? They are also comprised of protons, neutrons, pions, pi mesons. That is pi plus, pi minus, and pi naught. We know that there are three types of pi mesons. And they also constitute of K mesons, antiprotons, antineutrons. Although these antiprotons and antineutrons are formed in small number, which interact with the nuclei of the atmosphere. Okay? So, where the primary were only composed of proton alpha particles and the nuclei of carbon, nitrogen, oxygen, where the secondary rays are composed of protons, neutrons, pions, and the smaller elementary particles, that is pi mesons, K mesons, antiprotons, antineutrons. And these mesons, when interact with the nuclei, they are helpful in the production of the gamma rays, which causes the secondary or the cosmic showers. So we know that they are of pi mesons. So the pi mesons decays into mu mesons, and the mu meson will decay into electron, positrons, and neutrinos, antineutrinos. So these pi naught meson, neutral meson hai, that is decaying into the gamma ray photon of very high energy. And this gamma ray energy, when it is having energy more than 2 times the 0.51 mega electron volt, it is capable of production of the electron positron pair. So when gamma is having 2 m naught c square value, then it is producing electron positron pair. The electron positron pair may again produce the gamma ray, and gamma ray again produces electron positron pair. So in this way, the electron positron pair and the gamma ray production goes on continuously, which results into the cosmic ray showers. So at the height of, we have seen at the height of 15 kilometer, the secondary cosmic rays are composed of, they are composed of pi mesons, and since the pi mesons decays into mu mesons, so pi positive negative, mu positive negative mesons are composed at the height of 15 kilometers along with some protons and neutrons of very high energy. So if we look at the chart, what is happening, that from the outer space, first the primary particle is coming. So the primary particle is interacting with the nuclei of the atmosphere, as we had shown here, that the primary particle is interacting with the nitrogen and oxygen in the Earth's upper atmosphere. So the primary particle is interacting with the nuclei of the upper atmosphere, and it leads to the secondary cosmic rays. So this leads to the neutron and proton, where the neutron and proton are further interacting with the nucleus of the atmosphere, and then it leads to the pi mesons and mu mesons. So here we have the production of the pi plus minus meson, and here we have the neutral pi meson. So the pi positive negative will, we know that the pi positive and negative will decay into the mu positive and negative mesons. So the mu positive negative mesons will lead to the electrons, positrons, and the neutrinos, antineutrinos. So on this side we have this production, and these are regarded as the secondary cosmic rays, and these, the components of the pi positive, mu positive, electron, positrons, and the neutrinos are regarded as the soft component of the secondary cosmic rays. Similarly, if you see here what is the decay process of the neutral pi meson, so we see here that the pi positive is decaying into the very high energy gamma rays, where the gamma rays, while interacting with the nucleus of the atmosphere, with the carbon and the nitrogen or oxygen molecules of the atmosphere, they are leading to the production of the positron and electron. So when this gamma ray is totally internally converted into the positron and electron pair, and when this electron and positron interacts with the nuclei, they emit out gamma rays, and since the gamma rays are again very highly energetic, so again they are able to produce the electron positron pair, and the process goes on. And the whole process, this we can see that there is again a repetition of the process, and in this way we get a cosmic ray shower. So this is the brief introduction of how the cosmic ray shower happens in the atmosphere. So now you are aware of the cosmic ray shower. So let's look on the history of the cosmic ray shower, how the scientists had proposed the cosmic ray shower. First, the Rossi had explained the cosmic ray shower phenomena. What he did, he had arranged a large number of the detectors. The detector he used was the GM counter. So he had arranged a large number of the Geiger-Müller counter or the GM counter over a wide area and in a particular plane, and he saw that the cosmic rays that were coming from the outer atmosphere had been detected by the GM counter, and the GM counter's counting was being started. It was recording it, and it detected a large number of the particles that were produced simultaneously, and there was a significant increase in the number. So he was able to detect that how this significant effect, how the multiplication and avalanche multiplication of the intensity or the particles were detected. So this was the first phenomena that was detected by Rossi. Next, the Blackett had showed a photograph where he had showed the photograph that a single energetic electron, that one single electron is able to produce the shower. So the single energetic electron produces a large number of secondary particles. So a single energetic electron produces a large number of secondary particles, which when passed through a lead plate, and it resulted into shower of particles. So a single energetic electron produced a large number of secondary particles, and these secondary particles, the energetic electron which produced a large particle, had passed through a lead plate, and it resulted into the series of the particles. Next, the Bhabha, Hitler, Carlson and Oppenheimer had able to give a successful theory of the cosmic ray shower. So what they gave the theory that they were able to discover the pi naught meson, and they had found that the lifetime of the pi naught meson was very small, and that was just 0.5 into 10 raised to power minus 16 seconds. So since the lifetime of the pi naught meson was very small and it decayed into the two gamma ray photons very abruptly, so what they found that when the gamma ray in the high energy collision with the primary particles of the atmosphere, when they interacted with the primary particles, they were able to produce the electron and positron pair. So in high energy nuclear collision, primary particle produced multiple pi mesons, and 1/3 of the pi mesons were, means the pi mesons are pi positive, pi negative and pi naught. So 1/3 fraction is of the neutral pi mesons. So these neutral pi mesons decayed into two gamma ray photons. And when these gamma ray photons had enough energy, because they were high energy photons, they were having an energy of greater than 2 m0 c square. So when they had energy of 1.02 mega electron volt, then the gamma ray photons converted internally into the electron and positron pair. So when these electron or a positron interacted with the nuclei of the atmosphere, they had the collisions with the nuclei, so they gave rise to heavy nucleus. So the electron positron, and when the gamma rays had sufficient energy, they were able to produce the electron positron pair. Electron positron pair was able to produce gamma rays. Gamma rays were producing electron positron pairs, and the process was endless, and this resulted into the cosmic ray shower. As you can see here, that gamma rays are giving electron positron pair. When these is colliding with the nucleus, it is giving gamma. Gamma rays are again producing electron positron pair. The electron positron pairs, or the electrons, are interacting with the nucleus and they are producing gamma rays, and the series is continuously moving, which is resulting into the cosmic ray shower. So this is how the cosmic ray showers were detected, and we could see how the cosmic ray showers were detected. Thank you.